Want you to meet my great constituents here?
Oh, I'm Doris.
I'm Jack Jackson, Mr. President.
I'm an writer, publisher,
my daughter
editor.
Sent you a little note you put someplace and read it sometime. She'd appreciate you. She's one of your greatest of all friends.
Well, I appreciate
Sun, Moon, Star, such as you are, you know.
And I know this is a new experience for you.
Well, I've been here a few times, yes.
Yes. Well, why don't we gather here for a family picture,
all right?
All right?
Yep, one family.
And you two, why don't you ladies get in the middle, and it's a,
all right. Yeah,
it's a prettier picture.
Yes.
Well, all right, she's open.
I'd like to have one of them with you shaking hands for the magazine, if I may.
All right.
Well, let us get out of it, then.
Okay,
now we'll do it. Well, sir, it's really great pleasure. Congratulate you. I just say one of them. They add up to the big things that people love.
Well,
thank you for your remarks about Father's Day.
Thank you very much. We really do appreciate it.
President, I hope to see you soon.
Well,
thank you very much.
See you.
Thanks so much.
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Very proud of Marjorie. Thank you for
we are too.
We are going to miss her.
Valerie Lowrance.
Hello there.
Mr. President, it is an honor.
Well, I'm pleased to meet you. Congratulations. A little late because I'm like me, you're coming to the end of your term.
That's right. That's right. Okay. This is my parents, Fonseal and J.
Mr. Reagan, great to see you.
And this is Sister Frances Lawton. She's
nice
the Vice President's wife.
Well, I know you must be very proud parents.
Oh, we are.
We the office has asked me to bring you a little memento. We have America's Dreamiest cap that we'd like for you to have. And we understand that your wife is the honorary chairperson of the Partnership for Youth Program, Anti-Drug Program. And the Junior Miss Program has just become a sponsor and supporter of this, and the America's Dreamiest will now be an ambassador and spokesperson for her program. And we thank her for everything she does. Well, for the teenagers of America, and we wanted to thank her and give this to you.
Well, and to her. I will be very pleased to take that tour, and I thank you for this. Now, no one will think that I'm the junior me.
Oh, no. I don't think so.
Not a chance of that.
Then you and I get a picture, and then why don't we
okay.
get a group picture?
Okay, that would be an honor.
Great.
Thank you.
All right, now, why don't you all come in?
My goodness, I didn't know we were going to have a family photo.
Oh, good.
Yes, I think you're right in here. There we go. That'll make a nice picture.
Thank you.
Okay.
Well, thank you so much, sir.
Well, listen, thank you for all of this and for the message to Nancy.
Well, we appreciate both of you tremendously.
Thank you.
We really do. This is so nice. Thank you so much. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
You have a lot of support from the people in our part of the country down in Central Texas.
Well,
thank you.
Take the time to see it.
Thank you.
Great.
Have a nice day.
Thank you. Mr. President,
hi.
Mr. President,
Jim, how are you? Good to see you. See you.
Fine. Keep up that salt, you know, on 100%. This is Mr. Harvey Friedman.
Yes. President Harvey Friedman, how are you?
Commander of the Jewish War Veterans Corps, and have been doing a great job traveling all over the country.
Getting our picture taken here.
Yeah, I know we are. I see it. Yes. Thank you very much.
Well, listen. President,
I just want to say that, again, it's a pleasure to meet you and you're doing a great job. And it's, you know, something that this country is very, very proud of you, and I hope that you understand that.
Well, listen, I thank you very much. I hope I can deserve it, and I want to thank both of you also for the support that you've been, particularly on our SDI.
Oh, yeah.
Appreciate it.
Yeah, it's important. Thank you.
President, I wonder if I can have a word. Pen something for my son. His name is Brian. He's not too much trouble.
Got a pen right. Wait a minute. Your son, not too much
trouble.
B-R-I-A. B-R-I-A-N.
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 Maybe.
Oh, yeah. Great.
Thank you. Well,
oh, that's one. Thank you, Mr. President. Take care. Have a good day.
Thank you. Good to see you.
Nice to see you. We've been cleaning out the attic.
Oh.
And the inaugural committee wanted to, you to have an official album. Inauguration, which includes some of these things as well as pictures. You've got plenty of.
Well, my golly, though, but thank you very much.
I guess I was supposed to have signed that. Okay. We can do that in a hurry. Nobody told me about it. At least you know it's not a robo signature.
Okay. Well, listen, thank you very much. And incidentally, thank you very much for the vote on the Saudi.
Oh, I felt very strong.
Well, I appreciate it.
Thanks for taking care of our French friends this afternoon. I was supposed to be with them. Oh. I had to rush back to do a vote.
Oh. I'm going to ask you how you voted.
Or what? Or what? No, but that's a great museum project. Did they tell you they're going to put it in a bunker?
No,
they're going to utilize the German headquarters bunker right outside of Caen. And they're going to use this underground bunker as the museum. It's a huge thing, and they're going to use that. And so you'll get not only have the museum exhibits, but you'll actually be in the bunker area.
That's great.
Well, great to see you.
Good to see you.
Make you save you a little time.
All right.
These fellows behaving?
Pretty good.
Yeah. Not all the time. It's so fun when you behave all the time.
You're just getting so thin. You really ought to feed him up a little
bit. My wife keeps after me. She doesn't like him to get overweight.
I'm not going to disagree with your wife.
There you go. Yes, owner. Good to see you.
How you doing?
All right.
Present.
Robert. How are you?
This is Matthew Muxlow.
Matthew,
hello there. Bob, his mother Elizabeth.
Hello.
Hello there.
Pleased
to meet you.
There's an amazing young man. I met him up in Michigan. His great grandparents come from my state, but he would like to recite for you all the presidents, starting with George Washington.
I'm glad to hear it because I can't do that.
You ready?
George Washington, John Adams, Thomas Jefferson, James Madison, James Monroe, Andrew Jackson. Andrew Jackson, Marjorie, William Harrison, John Tyler, James Cooper, Stephanie Taylor, Millard Fillmore, Franklin Pierce, Jason Chan, Abraham Lincoln, Andrew Jackson, Lucy Stratt, Richard B. Mays, James Garfield, Chester Arthur, Grover Cleveland, Benjamin Harrison, William Cannon, Theodore Roosevelt, William Taft, Woodrow Wilson, Warren Harding, Calvin Coolidge, Herbert Hoover, Franklin Roosevelt, Harry Truman, Dwight Eisenhower, John Kennedy, Lyndon Johnson, Richard Nixon, Gerald Ford, Jimmy Carter, and Ronald Reagan.
He can also do that with the vice president attending each term of the president and their wives.
Well,
who's your favorite president?
Ronald Reagan.
Thank you very much. Why don't you all square around here?
Let's get a fan. Here, you can move the fan. I'll get on the head.
I still recite the shooting of Dan and Drew, the cremation of Sam McGee.
He might take him to the next press conference. He gets baffled. He's 7 years old, and he started this all by himself in 1985 itself.
It's just great. His teacher was talking about Presidents Washington and Lincoln, and he came home and began to study this encyclopedia. Just a trick.
If you give me my date, Mr. President, he'll tell you who was president that time. It's true.
Any date?
Yeah.
1878.
That was Rutherford Hayes.
And what is the
term? 1877
to 1881. When he's
vice president? His last name was Wheeler.
For heaven's sakes. I just happened to hit that date and I hadn't even thought myself. That was the president who was sitting well, not in this office, but here earlier, when from Queen Victoria in England, that desk arrived.
That's beautiful.
We have, it's made out of the planks of a British ship called the Resolute that was caught in the ice on Arctic exploration. And one of our whaling vessels found it and brought it out. And we refurbished it and shipped it over to England as a present. And when they decommissioned the ship under Queen Victoria and put it out of action, it's a thank you. We had them carve the planks into that desk and set it here. Rutherford B. Hayes was here too.
That's good.
When it came.
President Reagan, Matthew would like to present those gifts to you. And that's a book that was recently written by a local lady having to do with the history of our community. And Matthew wrote a note today, and the author wrote a note just Saturday. And so I'd like you to have that.
Well, thank you very much.
That's a paperweight that has a coin engraved just for the city of Brown City in the 1976 centennial. We had a centennial year during the bicentennial, and so we'd like you to have those.
Well, thank you very much.
The people from Brown City send a greet.
And thank you. You should be very proud, I know you are.
And we're pleased.
Keep it up.
Thank you, Mr. President. We appreciate it.
Pleased to invite us.
It's been a big day for
me. Appreciate that.
And the parents. These guys are nervous. This is Mike, or Scott, and Mike. Wife Perry and Paula down.
Thomas President.
And they finished third in the international competition in England, headed for China next in July, participate in soccer in China.
And I know that you were there only 3 years ago, and you're the youngest.
That's right.
Well, having been on a trip ourselves, I hope you'll have time also to get around to the sites. It's quite an experience.
Well, this is quite an experience for them. Are you nervous about it?
Scott's our striker. He scores our goals for us. And Michael is one of our best defenders. He plays the defense on the team.
Well, that's great.
Mr. President, appreciate it very much.
Now, what is this?
Soccer?
A bigger tournament or just play against China?
It's friendly games. We'll play against different teams in each city in China when we stop.
Oh. How long are you going to be gone?
About 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
2 weeks. Yeah.
If they get you near a place called Xi'an, X-I-A-N. That's the place where they uncovered those 800 or more life-size figures, soldiers, and in there under a hill is the tomb of this former warlord. And these, what he did to protect himself was have this stone army made. And they were each one of these figures on stone. And they estimate that if they continue excavating, there are probably 8,000 soldiers. And they're all standing there in formation. And they've covered them with a big building now, and you went in a kind of a balcony, and you look, and there they all are, including horses and chariots, all of that individually carved.
Makes you wonder if it worked or not.
We got to go down among them and stand there. Among them are all life size, and looking at them, you almost got a feeling maybe they could cover them.
Well, thank you, Mr. President. I know this is great.
And have a good time. Success to you. Just don't think that you're being bad guests if you decide to be.
They'll do their best, I'm sure. Thanks
for taking the time.
Well, it's a great pleasure.
Thank you.
And I don't know whether they'll feed you too many Chinese meals, but a veteran of China trips gave me one thing. He said, just don't ask what it is, eat it.
Thank you.